Yo, what is going on, guys? I'm in very low lighting, but that is okay because I am in high spirits. We are listening to Olivia Rodrigo's debut album, Sour, and I've been waiting all day for it. I'm really excited, man. Filipino power. I'm really happy for her, man. She's really doing a lot. I'm very happy for her, and I'm super, super proud of, like, her success. And she's just great. She's an example of hard work and sheer talent coming together to become a brand new artist. I think the timing of everything has been, like, very unique and very cool for her, you know, coming out with Driver's License on January 8th, and then ever since then, the song blew up, broke Spotify records, streaming records. She's 18 years old, and she's already taken the world by storm, literally. So, yeah, man, I'm very excited for her. I think her whole, like, team has been really awesome. Her aesthetic is great. The music videos are super dope, the ones that have come out already. Her live performances are sick. I feel like this warranted a reaction because it's cool to see a Filipino-American succeed and do really big things, and I find that very, very important as well. It's just very, very cool and very powerful. So, yeah, man. And her music so far that's been released has been incredible. So let's go ahead and listen to Sour. All right, so the first one is going to be Brutal. It's called Brutal, sorry. It's going to be great. Beautiful instrumentation. So caught up in the news of who likes me and who hates you, and I'm so tired that I might quit my job, start a new life. I'm so sick of 17. Where's my fucking team? Bro, that is such a rebellious type of sound. That's so good. That's like a pop punk kind of inspiration there. That's super good. I like the way she's singing to the beat too. It's like to the drum beat. She's literally like singing her verses, and she has such a unique voice. I don't even know how to describe her voice, man. Like, she's got like that kind of whispery but very like strong delivery with confidence. Enjoy your youth, I'm gonna cry, and I don't stick up for myself. I'm anxious and nothing can help. It's brutal out here. I can tell you right now, I didn't expect it to be like a pretty upbeat song to start this thing off. I was gonna be like, I was expecting a Driver's License type beat, like a, I woke up to thinking of you. Rebellious off the bat! Lately, I'm a nervous wreck, 'cause I felt that. Olivia, stop harmonizing like that! Crater is up next. And it's angelic as fuck. Ooh, I played dumb, but I always knew. Ooh, damn! God, she's really pouring her heart out. Who hurt you, Olivia? We already know, like, what Driver's License was about, but gee willikers, Batman. Phew. Clearly, she is a very talented writer. If you were true, there's no damn way that you could fall in love with somebody that quickly. That release is very important, and I think, you know, this is good music for if you were going through a tough time with somebody that you love or somebody that you thought was going to be the one. More friction than putting two fingers together. You snapped, sis! Honestly, I got a lot of, I got a lot of Conan Gray kind of aesthetics through that song, which I thought was really nice. Kind of gives me like a Heather vibe. Ah, and the bridge, her harmonies. We're only two songs in, not even three. The third one is Driver's License, though. So that is very exciting. We'll briefly listen through this because, again, who would skip this? Driver's License last week, just like we always talked about. One Step Forward, Three Steps Back is up next. And I know that this is like a homage, paying homage to Taylor Swift. 1 and 3 is the number 13 together. And I know that's Taylor Swift's lucky number. Okay, so it interpolates the song New Year's Day by Taylor Swift. And that essentially, I had to look up what that meant, but it means to alter or to insert between other things or parts. So it kind of like, so I'm guessing that it's supposed to kind of flow along with New Year's Day. Let's give it a listen. Definitely has that piano vibe, like New Year's Day. Called you on the phone today, just to ask you how you are. You got me fucked up in the head, boy. Never doubted myself so much. If that I give you power or that kind of stuff. Cause it's always one step forward and three steps back. Oh. Three steps back. Love me, want me, hate me, boy, I don't understand. No, I don't understand. Ooh, God! Okay, I keep pausing, I'm sorry. This is crazy, dude! It's fantastic! And I could definitely get the piano tinges of New Year's Day. It's a masochistic way. I couldn't find it all exciting. Like, which lover will I get today? Will you walk me to the door? It's back and forth, going over everything I said. It's one step forward and three steps back. Do you love me, want me, hate me, boy? I don't understand. No, I don't understand. Bruh, the way she ended that too, the roller coaster ride, the roller coaster line. It's such a roller coaster, but it's all I've ever had. Jesus, that really goes to show you the manipulation and the way that a relationship can, you know, make you feel trapped, but it's also, it's like both a thrill, but it's also something that also hurts you, but that you're afraid to leave, and you don't really know what else is out there. Up next we have Deja Vu, a classic. This might be my favorite off of the album thus far. A nice variety on the album. Alright, Good For You is, again, another one that we've heard, but is a fantastic song. And I really like the rock aspect of it. Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. Found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when we So that might actually be my favorite. Scratch that. Alright, Enough For You is the next song. And God, just by the title, God, it's gonna strike me, it's gonna be sad. I mean, we already know, but, who do I have to squabble with, Olivia? Who do I have to fight? Like, I have two fisticuffs. I can square up, I can quadrilateral up if I need to. Oh man, this might make me cry. I hope not. Wake up when we dated, cause I thought you'd like me more. If I looked like the other prom queens on the bachelor. Tried so hard to be everything that she liked. Oh man. I mean, she's already said everything that she feels, but I like how vulnerable she is in terms of writing a story and telling a story that shows her vulnerabilities, her insecurities. And you know, I don't know if this is necessarily like about her or if this is telling a story of somebody she knows, who really knows in the end. But I'm assuming this is from personal experience. She's had these kinds of relationships or has experienced that kind of inner like insecurity. Men ain't shit. That's all I'm saying. All I ever wanted was to be enough for you. God. Maybe I'm just not as interesting as the girls you had before. Put myself back before you found someone more exciting the next second you were gone. I loved you too much to think I deserve nothing. But don't tell me you're sorry, boy. Feel sorry for yourself. Cause someday I'll be everything to somebody else. Yes! Oh, Olivia! Fuck yes, girl! Find that one. Find the one. Fuck men and their standards for women. Ugh, fuck. You know what? Olivia's popping and you're not. I'm talking to all you dudes out there who are hurting women and, you know, especially the ones that did it to Olivia. Out of here with that. One of the best vocalists right now. God, the way she can control that is insane. That's one of my favorites for sure. I'm gonna keep saying that, I'm sure, but very well done, man. I got goosebumps. Very emotional. Again, PSA. Men ain't shit. Okay, next one is called Happier. Let's hope there's a happy song. Like that mix of like bitterness and frustration along with wishing them the best. You can really hear it in her singing as well as the progression of the song getting very intense. And I kind of like that classical. I forgot what the song was. There's a song of like what the instrumental is that it reminds me of, like that piano solo sounds very familiar. It reminds me of like a wedding and just like, you know, being at peace with that kind of chaos as well. And I think the way that she built that song to kind of be very intense along with her singing is really, really nice. Again, these interpretations could be a lot different than what you guys think or like what it's meant to be. And I'm sure we'll hear more from interviews exactly what she intended for these video or for these songs. Jealousy, jealousy. Oh boy. Phone across the room, cause all I see a girl's too good to be true. With paper white teeth and perfect body. It's not my lack, but it feels like that weight is on my back. Ooh. Beauty's not what I lack, but that weight is on my back. I think that's what she said. But still, that kind of, wow. This is really good in terms of like, highlighting insecurities but not letting them hold any truth. Very difficult to maneuver that, and believe me, I've been on the receiving end of that as well. Just as I'm sure a lot of other people have been through that kind of jealous phase. It's hard for her to not think those things, but at the same time she knows her self-worth. It's hard to kind of move past the heartbreak though. That was nice. I like the take on that, man. You never know what each song is gonna sound like. That sounds stupid knowing that this is a brand new album. But like honestly, since this is a debut album, it's kinda like you're discovering along with everybody else that what her sound is gonna be like. And this is beautiful. Favorite Crime is up next. I'm very excited for that one. Favorite Crime looks really good. And it's kind of like, the first thing I thought of was, No Body, No Crime by Taylor Swift. I'm not saying there's an inspiration there. I just wanted to point that out. That's where my mind went. I think it's kind of cool.
Know that I love you so bad. I let you treat me like that. I was your willing accomplice, honey. You fled the scene. Though I did, you buried me. One heart broke, four hands bloody.
One heart broke, four hands bloodied. Are you kidding me? Both her hands and the person she's with. Because both people got hurt, but one person's heart got broke. Wow. Gee, willikers, man.
The things you did. Well, I hope I was your favorite cry. Use me as an alibi. Across my heart.
I will say, man, I like that line, I defended you to all my friends. If you have to defend somebody that's in your life to your friends, then they shouldn't be in your life to begin with. Having conflicts to make you doubt your relationship with that person is not healthy. It should be a sign. And yeah, man. God, I've been there.
All the things I did, just so I could call you mine. Your favorite cry. Your favorite cry.
Tell me why that hit. Tell me why that hit. That's amazing. A great song. Again. Why does she have to have such a good voice? Like, it's not like she takes no breaks. Like, she has no breaks. Hope you're okay. And it doesn't have the proper punctuation. So, it sounds pretty edgy. But also, on a serious note, it sounds like it could be a bit sad. Here we go. Last song on Sour. Jesus Christ, I have to continue this.
We don't talk much, but I just gotta say.
Well, that was a great goosebumps-filled way to end the album. Didn't expect that. Holy shit. I hope whoever she was talking about in that song heard that and feels empowered and rejuvenated. And I hope that you guys fall back in touch. That was very, very, very powerful. Very descriptive. Again, God, the vivid imagery. And the importance of that is really amazing. I think that was the perfect way to end the song. Or the album, sorry. And emotional is an understatement. Whew, golly jeebers. I think that album was very, very good. I don't really know how to, like, process, like, the whole thing. I'd have to listen to it a few more times, which is, like, obviously normal. Let's recap, guys. Brutal started off as a very nice, like, upbeat, very, like, angsty teen kind of song. Traitor was very good. The first kind of step into the scene of heartbreak in the album sequence. Driver's License, one step forward, three steps back. You know, very, very sad. I think Driver's License still hits, obviously, the hardest because, you know, God, that's what started it all. And it not only brought a sneak peek into her songwriting ability, but also, you know, start a lot of drama, start the pot a little bit. Enough for You, very sad, but a really great song, great pacing, and, like, I like the guitar for it. Like, it's just, it's not super production heavy, which I think is good. It definitely delivers the message. It doesn't take away from anything. Happier is one of my favorites, man. That's a great one. Jealousy was also constructed beautifully. Favorite Crime, God, amazing yet again. Gave me kind of the similar vibe to Enough for You, because of the guitar, not because of, like, the content, but it was really very, very nice. The analogies, the writing in that one was really great. And then Hope You're Okay, we just went over. So, all in all, a very, very nice album. I think that a lot of the subject material is very focused around, you know, one particular theme. I think Sour is a good name for it because it shows, like, yeah, man, it's like, I like Sour because it is an uncomfortable kind of connotation. And it is also very playful with that discomfort. Yeah, it's something that is, it sits on the tongue. And, like, sort of like what the album art indicates. And, yeah, very sensitive. I think, for me, I like to overanalyze things, so if this sounds stupid to you, you can quit the video. I'm sorry, this is dumb. But I think it's cool, because I'm, like, breaking this down, like, bars. Whoa. But, you know, Sour. Her tongue was out, and obviously the word Sour is on it. And it's, like, not only, like, is it a bitter pill to swallow, ooh. But it's also, you know, it's a very sensitive part of the body. There's a lot of tastes and lingering, things that linger on your tongue that kind of, travel with you. And, with that being said, I don't know if that's, like, on purpose, but I think that's very cool. That's super dope. Overall, I think the album is really, really nice. A lot of different types of genres on that, and not what I expected going into it, I will say. I think it's a very great take on, like, pop music, and, like, you know, I think it's a very different approach to a lot of different songs that we don't really see a lot from artists. So, heck yeah, man. Props to you, Olivia. Absolutely killed it. I hope everyone else who is listening is enjoying it as well. Let me know what you think down below. What are your favorite songs? Did you agree with any of these, like, analyses? And yeah, which songs made you cry? I have a best friend named Emily who is very emotional when it comes to music, so if you are anything like her and can react pretty emotional to music, yeah, let me know what songs meant the most to you. Thank you guys for watching this, man. I had a great time. I had a very good time, man. I'm gonna listen to this album and further analyze / appreciate. I appreciate you guys watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out, dudes. Yeah. Go Philippines.